Labor Day is the most dangerous holiday period to be on the road with drunk drivers. The Department of Public Safety says typically during this time, a drunk driver is arrested every 4.6 hours, far higher than any other holiday period. In an effort to get drunk drivers off the roads, extra patrols will be on Minnesota roads through September 3rd. Orono police are warning people to not drink and drive. It's a simple request that many aren't following. In one night, they had 3 DWI arrests.
Plus, another driver suspected of DWI crashed right into someone's front yard. Ivory Hecker explains what this family saw when they woke up.
Yeah, devastation. Really?
That was John Bisey's reaction when he was awakened from his sleep Thursday night to a crash in his front yard. Police say a 41-year-old woman crash landed a new Mercedes on top of John's 2 trucks, totaling them.
Right up here, cleared the driveway. They were airborne because they never touched the driveway and they never touched the front bumper of the truck.
Police say the driver smelled strongly of alcohol and was slurring her words. She was taken to the hospital with minor injuries. For John, it quickly set in that his 1941 Chevrolet half-ton that had been passed through the family from his grandfather was destroyed.
And that's when I seen the 41 and the shock of knowing that that's gone after all these years of it being in my family.
He says he'd just thrown a bash celebrating the truck turning 75 last year. He says the collector car has been on the front page of a Target ad, in a PBS movie, and in many photo shoots.
It's somewhat rare to have a fully functioning, completely unrestored vehicle.
John says he bought the car from his grandpa in 1987 for $800.
It's been something that's been with us for a very long time, and I've personally owned it for 30 years.
For now, John is leaving both trucks in place until the insurance adjuster arrives, but he says the 41 Chevy is not something he can replace.
That just is incredibly disappointing.
As for the driver of the Mercedes, police say they conducted a field sobriety test and determined she was intoxicated. They say they're now waiting on blood sample results to determine whether to arrest her. And we're told a man that was riding with her at the time went home uninjured. Corey and Camille.
It's just really, people need to think more than twice about before getting it behind the wheel when they're drinking and driving, because it's not only can you, injure yourself or hurt somebody or even kill someone, but it's just expensive too. So.
Yep. I think that driver's lucky to be alive.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks,
Ivory. Going through the air like that, sure. Thanks, Ivory.